Hi, my name is Kevin Cavell, and I'm a product manager working for Agilent Technologies, soon to be Keysight Technologies. Today I wanted to give you an update on our 14585A control and analysis software. We've given the software the ability to connect to our new N7900 series of advanced power supplies. Previously, you were only able to connect to the N6705 series DC power analyzer, but now you can connect to both of these different families of power supplies. All of the major functionality of the software remains the same. The major update is now the ability to connect to the N7900, although we have made a minor update where you now have the ability to name and choose colors for the waveforms within the software. Previously, you did not have that functionality. So now let's take a closer look at some of the key features of the software.
We're now looking at the 14585A scope mode. You can see that I've preloaded a waveform into the scope. For all of the different functions that I'm going to show today, I've preloaded waveforms into them just to make the demonstration go a little bit faster. Even though I've preloaded waveforms, I did still connect to an instrument, one of our new N7951A power supplies. You can see here in the instrument control flyout window, I can click on to turn on the output, and you'll see we have it programmed to 7 volts. And this is just like interacting with the instrument from the front panel. All we have to do is click on instrument control again and the flyout window will go away. We get a bigger display of the scope. So this is the current pulses being pulled from a power supply, the N7951, by a motor. You can see the first two pulses here and then the third pulse is a little bit higher. These two pulses were done without any resistance and then the final pulse was done with some resistance, so you can see some more current is being pulled. If we want to know exactly how much current is being pulled, we can turn on the markers and take a look. The top of this pulse between these two markers is down here. The average is 2.2 amps. You can see we also get some extra information. We get the minimum, the maximum, the RMS, the peak to peak, and the charge slash energy. And then for the markers themselves, you can see exactly what point it's on. For marker one, we're at 278 milliseconds, and that point is 1.8 amps roughly. And then for marker two, we're at 1.3 seconds and 2 amps. If we wanted to take a look at how high this particular pulse is, we could just move the markers around that and then look at the maximum, and you can see that maximum is about 13, almost 14 amps. So this is the scope mode. You set it up exactly like an oscilloscope. We set the time per division, the offset, which is a pre or a post trigger. Here we have a pre trigger by setting -2 seconds. Here's the number of points we want to acquire. That's the number of points that the digitizer inside the power supply will return to us. And then we can set up our trigger. We can trigger on voltage or current, the scope run button, the arb run button, or we can actually set up an external trigger. These are the pins on the back of the power supply. We can do triggers off of automatically, a single or triggered, just like a scope, and we can change from positive to negative slope and set the trigger level down here, or we can actually pull this just to change the trigger level. This is again just like a scope, and it's for short-term measurements. If we wanted to do a long-term measurement, we would go to the data logger mode. Just click on data logger here. Again, I've pre-populated with data. This top waveform is voltage and this bottom waveform is current. This is actually the voltage of a battery, and we're using the N7951A as an electronic load to pull these pulses of current. The data log is approximately 32 minutes long, and you can see over the course of those 32 minutes, the voltage slowly decreases until about this point right here. And we can see that marker two is about 27 minutes when the voltage of the battery drops off. So this is a great way to do battery drain analysis or any other type of long-term measurements. Again, you get the markers to see the different values for the measurements along the way, depending on what you're looking for. If we want to take a different look at this long-term data, we can use our Ccdf or complementary cumulative distribution function. We could take this data from the data logger, go to the menu, click on convert to Ccdf. I've done this already, so we'll just go over to the Ccdf window and take a look. Here you can see the data shown in a different way. This is a logarithmic scale. On the y-axis we have percentage, and on the x-axis we have the amplitude. and you're showing voltage, current, and power. And with changes in the y-axis, so up and down changes will show changes in the percentage of time it's at that amplitude value. And then changes left to right on the x-axis, which shows it changes in amplitude. So for example, this is the voltage waveform here. You can see that if we choose this point right here, it's about 6.1 volts, and it's at 6.1 volts for about 10% of the time. So that's a different way of looking at the data. More quickly see where your device is spending most of its time. Finally, we have our arbitrary waveform mode, where we can create any number of different waveforms. You can see here, I've created a sine wave with a sync pulse and then a triangle wave. It's very easy to do waveforms with the software. There's three different ways. You can use built-in. You can see you have a number of different choices to choose from. You can choose a formula. There's a number of different formulas to choose from as well. And then you can also import data. So we can take a measurement, in the scope mode, and we can import that into the arbitrary waveform generator and then actually have the power supply reproduce that. So let's take a look at the waveform that I created. So we just have to cancel out of here. We'll go back to the scope and we'll just go ahead and clear the imported data. And all I need to do to run the arbitrary waveform that I've created is click the ARP start button, but before I do that, I'm going to click on the scope start button to start the measurement, and there's pre-trigger filling up, and then if I click on the ARB, it'll create the waveform, and you can see we triggered on that waveform, and it's just filling up the buffer with data, and as soon as it's done, we'll see the data on the screen. So there you go. So this is it coming down from 7 volts to start the waveform, and then we have our sine wave, our sync pulse, and our triangle wave. And again, if you wanted to take a look at more of the data, we can turn on the markers. We can look at one period of our sine wave here, and we can see that the frequency is 990 millihertz, or just about 1 hertz, just like what we programmed in the arbitrary waveform generation window.
So you saw some of the key features of the 14585 control and analysis software. Again, the major update is the ability to connect to the N7900 series of advanced power supplies. All of the other major features remain the same. If you happen to have any questions, please feel free to use the comment section below, and we'll do our best to get back to you. Thanks for watching.